Hi to everyone, so welcome to this QA unit video, and today we'll talk about the concept of the tipping point, understand its motivation, reasons, and what we can do with this concept within quality engineering. So let's start with a concrete example of a tipping point we all know about. The most common one a bit from the history is, for example, Coca-Cola. The iPhone, we all know about, and its largest spread and one of the major sources of revenue for Apple. DevOps is also widely known in the IT ecosystem. Windows, we don't need also to talk about it. I have more doubt about vegan, for example, but maybe in 20, 30 years with problems of food, it may become a bit and reach the tipping point. And electric cars, maybe we are at the tipping point with all Tesla brand and all investment in that area. So if we go and look a bit more at the formal definition of tipping point, so it's really a pivotal and inflection point of change with system thinking and also organization, society, etc. And really it's a pivotal point where things will start to drastically change in the ecosystem, and normally new practice will replace the old one. And this cumulative series of changes that make a lot of changes happening in the ecosystem and in culture, for example. To that effect, you can read the book The Tipping Point from Malcolm Gladwell, which is very good at deeping dive in this topic, the concept and implication for also non-IT related topics, and very interesting in terms of change management. So if we deep dive on from our perspective of quality engineering, so the chasm is really the pivotal point we are aiming at in the quality engineering and the concept of the tipping point. So it's really a point where we divide in two parts the ecosystem. So on the left, we have the early market, that once the chasm is reached and the tipping point passed, we reach then the mainstream market with specific subcategories. We start on the left with the innovators and the early adopters, to then move to early majority and the remaining part of late maturity and laggards that will adopt once the overall system will have adopted it. If we look at on top, there is two interesting parts. There is that before the tipping point, we have a scarcity and it's very normally hard to reach that mountain. But once we reach the tipping point, we are clearly near the top of the mountain, and we have social proof, and we can use a series of other techniques like network effect. And you also know when we start to get down the mountain, we already quite see the snowball effect, where things just cascade by themselves with low effort. If we make a parallel with IT, DevOps, quality engineering, etc., we can do it on a variety of topics, looking at the adoption curves of technology, for example. I did it in this example with the InfoQ report of DevOps and cloud technology. And we can see that, for example, the chasm is coming from the category in yellow for all hope continuous testing, for example, widespread adoption of accelerate in terms of performance measurement, transformational leadership. It's all serious topic. We talk a lot in Q unit. So it's very interesting to have a look at that, so that then you can also decide in your ecosystem, is the right time to be on the left as a strategy or a specific investment for what we want to reach for our user, or is it better to wait that it reach an early majority, because probably there will be more offering from vendors, a bit of lower cost, more maturity, less risk. So it's also a very interesting perspective to have for both change management, when you need to implicate people to adopt quality engineering practice, but also to choose specific methodology, technology, type of organization, model, etc. It's a very actionable model. So if we look a bit more of the link between tipping point and quality engineering, we first need to understand the two key elements of the tipping point. So firstly, it requires a series of cumulative small changes that bring value to the ecosystem. So this is a very fundamental point. The second one is that once we reach that point, the ecosystem will really rapidly and dramatically adopt these new practices. And this is what when change are happening in fact in an organization. And this is what we're trying to achieve with quality engineering. It's to replace the old practices with the quality engineering one. So for For quality engineering concretely, it means that continuous improvement is key so that we are able to implement small changes to our users. And second point, they must bring value because they need to meet the requirement of being significant enough. Another consideration for quality engineering is that as we need to reach the tipping point, we don't need to impact the overall ecosystem in an organization. So it means that if we want to implement quality engineering in a team, for example, of 100 people, our first objective should not be to change all the team to adopt quality engineering. We need to start with the team that will enable us to reach the chasm and the tipping point to then cascade on the overall organization. That way, we limit our effort, we increase our probability to succeed at it, and we are most importantly faster at achieving our goal and bringing value to the users. The next question that comes when we say that is when you reach the tipping point, in fact, so we need to have metrics always to have targets. It's what drives objective and result. So the tipping point in what I've been studied, because it is backed with a lot of research, is between 10 to 60%, and it's a bit the range you see if we have the early adopters and the two categories summing up from the previous curve. So it means that if you have 100 or 1000 people to transform for quality engineering in your organization, in fact, you need to focus on the 10 to 16 most prominent person to adopt quality engineering, where there is most value, less risk, etc. To that effect, there is a lot of the techniques, etc. we can use. We will deep dive in those in the next videos, but it's really the tipping point is really a good practice to have a perspective, global perspective, before taking specific actions. So it's fundamental in your strategy, type of priorities and action you set up. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe and put a like or make a comment. I will be happy to continue the discussion. There is also a full article making a deep dive on how to reach the tipping point of quality engineering. You can find it on the blog. And I say thank you for your time and bye bye. See you next time.